Thank you. Well, that's basically the meaty part of the program right there. And now we have to cleanse our palate a bit with a very tiny piece by Edwin Lemaire, perhaps the greatest organ virtuoso of his time, about 100 years ago. Edwin Lemaire was best known for his transcriptions. He was municipal organist at several large cities, and he was the dedicatory recitalist on this instrument in 1908. So I'm playing one of his tiniest pieces, this little descriptive thing that'll just let you hear some of the tiny flutes, the cuckoo. Only two or three cuckoos there. So now for something radically different. Some of you may know this piece. A fellow from Germany took what was basically a German praise band song and did this to it. Well, now for a piece that is more suitable to the time period of this instrument from, let's say, the 1920s. This piece by Ralph Kinder. Ralph Kinder was very active in the Philadelphia area, apparently well-beloved and a fine player, fine composer. So this is a style of sort of light music that would have been found on organ programs at that time. If you happen to be wealthy enough to have a home with a pipe organ installed, such as Mr. Eastman had, it's not unlikely that you would have heard this piece at that time. So hoping for blue skies to return in springtime. daffodils sprouting everywhere. So now we move to a piece by Richard Purvis, who spent the majority of his career in the San Francisco area, born there, and went to school at Curtis, studied with Alexander McCurdy, returned back to San Francisco, and had a very long tenure as organist and master of the choristers at Grace Cathedral. I never met Richard Purvis, nor heard him play live, but I know his compositions, I know many of his students. Clearly, he left a terrific legacy of teaching. This particular piece was written, I think, or published in 1968 from a collection of pieces that essentially are drawing on folk tunes from the Scottish Highlands. And this is a bit of a tone poem. You're going to hear a lot of colors shifting and some interesting harmonies back and forth. It's a good vehicle for this instrument. If you're nodding off after lunch, this might help you along that way. But, a beautiful piece from Richard Purvis is Of Moor and Fen.
Thank you.
And to conclude, a piece that we're a little puzzled by the composer of this. My music says Humphrey J. Stark, but he seems to be an elusive soul. There's a Humphrey J. Stewart that was composing at the same time. We know it was published in a collection in 1909. My copy is from an English edition that does not seem to have a date. And I received my copy from Steve Warner, organist, at the Jefferson Avenue Presbyterian Church in Detroit. Terrific Skinner organ for those organ geeks out there. I heard this piece and I thought, that's just great, I have to have it. And it's perfect for this instrument. Given the time and the clock ticking on, I think I'll avoid at least one of the repeats in it. But this is the sort of thing that would have been really commonly heard in the early 20th century for a postlude or to end of a program. So I hope you've heard some things you've enjoyed today. If you're interested in more of this, the Rochester Theater Organ Society is hosting the National Convention of the American Theater Organ Society this July, first week. So check into their website. There will be a program here played by a British organist who's brilliant. You won't be disappointed. So, thanks very much.